morning, Asalaamu Alaikum, and welcome to a very special edition of Community Matters. Was a very sad day in the history of Bangladesh. I'm sure you'll all remember the tragedy of the Rana Plaza complex, where more than 1,100 people died and many more were injured. Today, people are still suffering as a direct result of our fashion supply chain. On 24th of April 2014, people around the world, from designers and icons to high street shops and high couture, from cotton farmers and factory workers, to campaigners and academics, the media, and many other individuals who care about what they wear, will come together to launch a Fashion Revolution Day campaign. This evening, I want to learn more about Fashion Revolution Day, and who better to talk to than the founder themselves, along with some supporters and some live studio audience. Without any further ado, let me introduce the members of my panel. On my left here, we have Carrie Summers, the founder of Fashion Revolution Day. Welcome to the show, Carrie.
Thank you.
Further to my left, we have Yasmin Khatun, who is on the board of Fashion Revolution Day and a journalist. Welcome to the show. On my nearest to my right is a very familiar face, I'm sure, on Bengali TV. Baroness Uddin, who is a peer in the House of Lords. Welcome to the show. And on my furthest to my right is Azizur Rahman, a very successful businessman and on the board of British Bangladesh Chamber of Commerce. Welcome to the show.
Assalamu alaikum.
Okay. I think a very good place to start off with is try and get some context of the conversation we're about to have. So if I can start off with Kerry, if you can tell us a little bit about, in terms of the work that you've done over the years, before we come on to Fashion Revolution Day.
Yes, I own a fair trade fashion brand called Pachacuti.
Okay.
And we've worked for 22 years now.
Mm-hmm.
In fair trade fashion, we supply a lot of boutiques. We export a lot, predominantly to Japan. And we've participated in three different pilot projects over the last 5 years. One of those is particularly relevant to Fashion Revolution Day, and that was the EU Geo Fair Trade project, which was looking at transparency in the supply chain.
Okay.
So we actually mapped the GPS coordinates of each one of our Panama hat weavers,
okay,
as well as collecting around 60 different social, economic, and environmental indicators to actually measure progress over the years, because it's no good just saying that you're ethical or sustainable.
Mm-hmm.
You actually need to be able to prove it and show that you are.
Okay, so this fits in quite nicely in terms of why you've come up with this idea. We're going to come back to the fashion on it. Yasmin, what about you? How did you, in terms of before you got involved, have you done on other projects? Tell me a little bit about you.
As a broadcast and print journalist, fashion has always been something I've been interested in. My first published piece was about DIY couture.
Okay.
So it's always been something I've liked to work around. As a journalist, you want to explore, find out, uncover issues for the public to understand, for you to understand.
Mm-hmm.
It's like doing a piece of research that
sure.
people then get to read. As well as working on documentary features, and my news programs, I've always looked into the garments industry, ethics behind the garments industry, and that's how it sort of came about, where I was interested in what's going on, especially after the Rana Plaza.
How did you get involved in the board? How did you get involved in the project?
Well, as a young journalist, I was exploring the garments industry. I produced a documentary last year on
okay.
ethical fashion soon after the Rana Plaza factory collapse,
okay.
and talking to the Ethical Fashion Forum, Kerry, and the different partners involved. Last year, we were at the Source Summit,
mm-hmm.
where people from all over the world were involved to discuss ethics in the garments industry. We came together to discuss how we can challenge the issues that we're being faced with,
mm-hmm.
how we can be productive, how we can change things, and sitting down together we came up with a good few ideas and working on taking on from the ideas that Kerry brought forward in terms of having something called
mm-hmm.
Fashion Revolution Day that we could all work together with
okay.
under a banner.
Brilliant. We'll come back to Fashion Revolution Day. Baroness Uddin, have you worked on similar sort of over the years? You must have worked on many a different projects before coming into and getting involved in this. Tell us a bit more about some of the work you've done, especially around this particular area of garments, fashion, etc.
Obviously, you can tell I'm no fashionista, but like Kerry
and looking lovely,
Yasmin. But I'm very committed. I've always been very committed to promoting some of the good practice in Bangladesh
uh-huh.
to do with fashion. I'm very keenly aware and interested in silk weaving and the small cottage industry that
sure.
really support particularly women. I mean, the fashion industry in the high street have meant, and our interest in garments, cheap garments in particular, have meant that you know, the employment of Bangladeshi women have sort of catapulted beyond recognition. So I think I'm very interested in all the other social, environmental, Kerry's words, and economic aspects of these issues. And of course, none of us could have not been involved in what happened post Rana Plaza. Sure. And so generally, I'm interested in what's going on. So it's,
well,
this
I'll,
is a,
I'll come back to you in terms of why you're supporting this particular project, etc. If we can just go to Aziz Bhai. What sort of projects and things have you worked on before? Obviously, you're supporting this particular project, and what made you?
Well, tonight I'm representing the Chamber of Commerce because
yeah?
we are hoping to put an event in Birmingham
okay.
on the 24th of April. Okay. But as a Chamber of Commerce, we work to with various business, with potential investors for Bangladesh to improve bilateral trade between the UK and Bangladesh.
Mm-hmm.
And we have taken many delegations to Bangladesh, and some have invested, and many have shown interest to invest. We work closely with the garments industry, promoting the garment industry, which is one of the biggest industry to come out of Bangladesh, a real success story. And my other hat that I do work with Oxfam. I have been involved with Oxfam for over 20 years. So when I heard about the Revolution Fashion Day, of course, it's quite close to my other work.
Excellent. We're going to come back to and talk a bit more about Fashion Revolution Day. As I mentioned, that we do actually have a studio audience today. If I can ask one of our studio guests to ask who's got a question for the panel. Syed Atikul Hussain, who's a senior IT consultant from Redbridge in Essex. I believe you have a question.
Hi there. Yes, I do. I'd like to ask the panel, what is the thinking, aims and objectives behind Fashion Revolution Day?
There's two of you ladies haven't been involved. Kerry?
Yes, I mean, we had a lot of meetings over the first month, sort of between about June and October, November, actually working out what was our vision, what was our strategy, because we were such a diverse group of people. But ultimately, our vision was really quite simple. We believe in a fashion industry which values people, the environment, profits and creativity in equal measure. And it's everyone's responsibility to ensure that this happens. And so to reach this vision, we've got four different objectives. We want to show the true cost of fashion and its impact at every stage in the process of production and consumption, because actually most of the environmental impact of all of the clothes that we wear is during the consumer phase through washing and laundering and disposal. We want to connect the supply chain, so we want the farmers to be able to tell their stories, we want the garment makers to be able to tell their stories, and we want them to have a voice so that they can connect through to the consumers. We want to celebrate best practice, so we want to celebrate best practice wherever it's found and show that change is possible. And finally, we want to work towards long-term change in the garment industry and get consensus from everybody who's involved in Fashion Revolution Day, and that includes the farmers, the garment makers, the dyers, about what change needs to happen.
Excellent. Is there anything you want to add, Yasmin?
Well, adding to that, I mean, the Bangladeshi garments industry is worth £13 billion. That's $20 billion. I mean, that's an incredible amount of money. And I think the main focal point to me when I thought about it was, is this translating to the workers on the ground, when it clearly isn't? So many people are suffering from dire consequences. You know, when we saw the Rana Plaza factory collapse, what's important to remember is that wasn't an isolated incident. It wasn't that this is one thing that's happened, you know, a few months before there was a Tazreen fire. A week later, there was water poisoning in factories. So why is there this level of corruption? So in terms of vision, it's a vision for change. It's a vision to have more ethical practice in the industry. A vision to highlight consumerism and consumption. You know, in the West, you know, we so easily pick up things and throw them away, you know, but where are these items going? You know, where are they ending up in landfills? You know, we know the amount of waste that there is in the world. I mean, as Muslims, as a Muslim myself, you know, in terms of having some level of accountability, you know, in Islam, these things are very, very important. So when you bring in British Muslims, you know, what are they doing? And that's something that was very important for me, as well as the wider group of people who are acting upon this and are ready to implement some change.
Okay. Thank you. Azizbhai, how did you get involved in the first instance with the whole fashion revolution?
Well, I've worked with a lady called Elizabeth, who mm-hmm. happened to live in Oxford, and mm-hmm. she's one of the person involved in ethical fashion. Mm-hmm. And as the Chamber has worked with her, we did a fashion show about 10 years ago, mm-hmm. or 10 years ago, and she actually produced the whole show. Okay. Through that, she knows I'm also involved with the not just the Chamber but also other work with the communities, mm-hmm. with the wider community. But she approached me and said, look, this is what's happening because of the Rana Plaza disaster which happened last year. Would you like to get involved? As soon as I heard it, of course, I said yes, you know, anything to create more awareness, anything to see if we can have better practice, anything to help the community get involved.
Sure.
Yes, so that's how I got involved. And of course, as I said, I'm here to represent the Chamber today. Mm-hmm. And straight away I thought, what can we do as a Chamber? And I came up with speaking to Elizabeth is perhaps we should have some sort of a gathering or get together in Birmingham where we will have a fashion show, some sort of fashion show, and show the best practice of the garment industry, of the Bangladesh garment industry, which there is a huge amount of praise to be made because
we'll talk more about the exact activities and something. What about you, Baroness, in terms of your involvement? What made you want to support this particular cause?
Well, of course, you know, anything to change what's happening to those who are involved in production of garments mm-hmm. and change their lives is something that we can't shy away from. I mean, I became very involved in very lately through Azizbhai. Azizbhai talked to me about it. I've spoken to Elizabeth Lusker. I know of her work, and so of course I want to contribute. But I think that Parliament itself has a very big responsibility. This. To change the vision and to achieve the objectives that mm-hmm. are set out by Carrie and Yasmin, you need very long-term commitment and a multifaceted approach to ensure that a whole range of organizations and institutions are involved. And I think from Parliament point of view, I think it's very critical that those of us who are constantly talking about empowerment of women, we cannot turn our cheek. We can't talk about Syria and we can't talk about Afghanistan constantly and because it's a state of war. We've got to also say there are state of wars going on with people's lives all the time, including in garment industry. Mm-hmm. And it's very important that any one of us who are able to contribute in any small way, I think, which is what the very important mm-hmm. Objective is, that we do so.
Thank you. We are now coming to the end of the first part of the show. We are discussing Fashion Revolution Day with the founder of Fashion Revolution Day and some of our guests and supporters. Please do stay with us. We'll be back very shortly.
আপনারা দেখছেন কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্স সজনে মাহবুব এন্ড কো অ্যাকাউন্টেন্টস।